Welcome student, we are to study electrostatics today. So we'll start from electric flux. It is denoted by phi E. So we know that every electric charge produces electric field in the surrounding space. Electric field can be represented in different ways. If this is a charge, it produces electric field. This field is represented by electric lines of force. The electric lines of force passing normally through unit area is called electric intensity. So we define this electric intensity
dot
be S bar. It is A bar dot B bar equal to AB cos theta, like this. So electric flux is a dot product of electric intensity and area vector. If ds is a small part of large surface, yes, then electric flux through this large surface can be found using formula: total electric flux through large surface phi e is equal to integration of d phi e. If we divide this large surface into small part each of area ds, and if we get total number of lines of force passing normally through this area, so we write it is equal, this is a closed integration, it is equal to E bar dot ds bar. It is like this, E bar dot ds bar. So this electric flux passing normally through any surface. Now this is a mathematical method to find electric flux. There is another method to find electric flux. It is a Gauss theorem. Now we will study Gauss theorem. We have seen Coulomb's law in electrostatics, which gives the relation between electric charge and electric field. Similarly, Gauss law also gives relation between electric charge and electric field, but some other way. So this is the alternative method to find relation between charge and electric field. We can write statement for Gauss law. Statement can be remembered if we remember this equation: phi e is equal to q net divided by epsilon 0. We can consider a closed surface area of any cell, and if charges are situated inside it, it may be q1 or q2 or q3 dash dash dash, placed in a medium of permittivity epsilon. So Gauss law states that the electric flux passing through this closed surface will be like this. Which encloses electric charges or surrounding the electric charges is equal to 1 upon epsilon 0 times net charge or total charge enclosed by the surface. So we write, what is phi e? Phi is net electric flux through a closed surface surrounding electric charges is equal to 1 upon epsilon 0 times the total charge enclosed by surface. Total charge means we take q1 plus q2 plus q3. So we can write statement: the net electric flux through any closed surface surrounding electric charges is equal to 1 upon epsilon 0 times total charge enclosed by that surface. If we take some example, this is a small sphere of radius r, and if a charge plus q is situated at its center, so you can find total electric flux passing through this surface area, phi e is equal, if it is placed in the medium of permittivity epsilon 0, so we can write 1 upon epsilon 0 into total charge enclosed, it is q upon epsilon 0. So this electric flux is independent on the dimensions of surface. If you take a large surface, consider sphere of radius 2r, if same charge is situated at point q, now electric flux passing through this sphere will be phi e equal to 1 upon epsilon 0 times total charge enclosed by the surface. This will get same answer. The radius is r, radius is 2r, means electric flux is independent of size of closed surface. Also, if you consider like this, same charge is enclosed in a cube. If charge plus q situated inside a cube, then total flux passing through the surface area of cube, phi e is equal to q divided by epsilon 0. So we conclude that the electric flux does not depend upon shape and size of the surface. So this is Gauss theorem. So remember this equation, electric flux phi equal to q net is total charge enclosed by surface given by permittivity of medium epsilon 0. So this is Gauss law, the net electric flux through any closed surface surrounding electric charge is equal to 1 upon epsilon 0 times total charge enclosed by the surface. Now we will study some applications of Gauss theorem. Electric intensity due to uniformly charged spherical cell or holosphere. Where to find electric intensity for charged holosphere? For this, we consider a small sphere having radius capital R, its center O. It is placed in the medium of permittivity epsilon. If it is air or vacuum, we can write here epsilon 0. For any other medium, we can write epsilon. And if a charge plus Q is deposited on it, due to symmetry, it spreads uniformly on its surface. We have to find electric intensity due to uniformly charged spherical surface. So we consider a point P outside the sphere and distance R from its center. We consider a point P which is at distance R from center of sphere A and to find electric intensity at P using Gauss theorem, we must assume a closed surface which encloses these charges. So draw an imaginary sphere V having radius small r and which is concentric with sphere A. This is a sphere V. It is called Gaussian surface because it encloses the charges. So draw a sphere V having radius small r and which is concentric with sphere A. Due to symmetry, all points on surface of sphere are at equal distance from this charges. To find electric intensity at point P, let E be electric intensity at point P. It is directed radially outwards. It is electric intensity every point of this surface of sphere B is at equal distance from these charges. So magnitude of electric intensity is same for all points on surface. Now consider a small area of this sphere V. Let it be ds around point P. It is around point P. So using mathematical method we can find electric flux passing through this area ds. Electric flux through ds. It is d phi e is equal to number of lines of force passing normally through unit area is e. Therefore, total number of electric lines of force passing normally through area ds will be e into ds into cos theta. As electric intensity is directed radially outward, the angle between electric intensity and area vector is 0. So where Q theta is equal to 0 degree. Hence, cos theta will be 1. So, electric flux d phi e is equal to e into ds. If you take a small area ds here, or here, or here, for all these points on surface of sphere will get same as. So, total electric flux passing normally is like this. It is passing normally outward, so we can find total electric flux through sphere B is phi E is equal to close integration of E into ds. If we integrate, if we take addition of all these factors, we will get close integration of E bar E into ds. As magnitude of electric intensity is same for all points on this sphere B, so it is constant E into integration of ds. If you integrate all these ds, you will get total surface area of the sphere. So we can write it is equal to E into 4 pi r square. This equation first. So we can find electric flux using mathematical method. Now we can find same electric flux using Gauss theorem. Total electric flux passing normally through this Gaussian surface, that is sphere B, is equal to, it is Q net, means total charge enclosed by the sphere B is Q, divided by epsilon 0. This is equation second. If we equate equation first and second, we can write E into 4 pi r square equal to Q divided by epsilon 0. We have to find electric intensity E. We can write electric intensity E at point P is E equal to Q divided by 4 pi r square into epsilon 0. If you rearrange these terms, we can write E is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q divided by R square. This is equation 3. So this is the expression for electric intensity at a point outside the charge sphere. We can write it in another form. If sigma is surface charge density of sphere A and charge Q is deposited on it, it spread uniformly, therefore surface charge density of this sphere A, sigma equal to total charge divided by its surface area. So we can write sigma is equal to Q divided by area of the sphere A is 4 pi r square. Therefore, Q is equal to 4 pi r square into Q. So put the value of Q in expression of electric intensity. We can write E is equal to 4 pi r square into Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 into r square. 4 pi get cancelled. It is equal to sigma q equal to 4 pi r square sigma. So you can write sigma into r square divided by epsilon 0 into small r square. So this is fourth formula. So this is another formula for electric intensity. E equal to sigma into capital R square divided by epsilon 0 into small r square, where capital R is radius of charge sphere and R is distance of point from center of charge sphere. We write two cases. There are two special cases. First, if point P is on sphere A, if point P is on sphere A, then this small r equal to capital R. We can write small r equal to capital R. Therefore, the expression for electric intensity becomes E is equal to sigma into capital R square divided by sigma into capital R square, epsilon 0, sigma divided by epsilon 0. If there is no vacuum or air, if there is another medium, we can write E equal to sigma upon epsilon 0 k. And second case, if point P is inside sphere A. If it is inside the sphere A, there is no charge inside the sphere, hence Q equal to 0. Therefore, surface charge density inside sphere will be 0. We can write Q equal to 0, that is, surface charge density sigma is equal to 0. Therefore, electric intensity E inside charge sphere is 0. These are two cases. Thank you.